What are you going to do?
Hold a board meeting. Close the mine.
You should have done it months ago, Alec.
Don't you think I know that?
There'll be trouble.
I know that too. Max, I'm sorry.
For me, it's just a job. For you?
The whole shooting match, isn't it? Max, about the men,
I'll tell him.
Thanks.
I've been shopping.
Huh?
Well, darling, all those old colleagues of yours, you don't want to be ashamed of me, do you?
What?
The party in London tomorrow. Your old firm. Now, don't tell me you'd forgotten.
I don't think we're going.
Of course we're going. We've got a hotel suite booked for 3 days and all sorts of arrangements made. Will you hand me the towel, please, darling?
Rosa, I'm going to talk to you.
Oh, don't worry, darling. I bought everything by credit card.
Rosa, now look.
Oh, Alec, please, some other time.
Now, Rosa, just listen to me now.
I know you're going to tell me that we've got to cut down, that we have, now what's the expression? Liquidity problems.
No, I'm going to tell you that we're broke. Bust. No more credit cards. No more bloody credit.
Wonderful.
Oh,
hello, just getting some fresh air. Warm in there.
Yeah.
Betty Kadek, from Australia.
Alec Hamill.
I know. I've had dealings with your old firm since the Poseidon days. I run a mining consultancy in Perth.
Kadek?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I remember the name.
You working for another company?
No, I'm on my own. I formed a consortium to my tin and corn.
Ah, that's a high-risk game.
Yes, you could say that.
High profits to compensate, I hope.
Well, we're getting by.
You're pretty well qualified, I seem to recall.
Well, if degrees mean anything these days.
They are where I come from. If I had your background, I'd have made a million.
Western Australia?
Could still make it. Don't believe the nickel boom is over. He's ready to break wide open again.
Yes, I've heard rumors.
A man like you out there, ever thought of it, Australia?
Oh, people are looking for you, Alec.
This is Mr. Kadek from Perth. My wife, Rosa.
Mrs. Hamilton.
Hello. Perth, is that near a place called Pilbara?
Not quite. About half the size of Europe away.
I have a cousin on some vast acreage out there. People called Geraghty.
I've heard of them. Cattle barons. At least they used to be. They own a gold mine.
That's right.
Cousin Janet was over here last year, and Alec was rather smitten. Weren't you, darling? Well, it's too cool for me out here, Mr. Kadick. But it's nice to have met you.
My pleasure, Mrs. Hamilton. Very pretty woman, your wife.
Yes.
About Australia, have you ever thought of it?
Sometimes.
You'd be in on the ground floor, believe me. It's all going to happen again. If you ever do get there, look me up. I am leaving tomorrow. Can't wait to get back.
Well, have a good trip.
Thanks.
Oh, you are in the book, aren't you, if I do happen to get there?
Kadick Consultants. You'll find me on top of the tallest building. From my office window, I've got the best view in Perth.
Australia. You must be crazy. Just because some man at a party
not
told
only
you...
because of him. Got to find a way out.
Run away like a criminal?
Or stay and be labeled one.
You've really made a mess of things, haven't you?
Yes, you could say that. You could truly say that.
It seems simple enough to me, darling. If the tin has run out, you tell the investors.
Tell them what? That it ran out 6 months ago? That we've been drilling into solid granite ever since?
Well, why have we been doing that?
Because I gambled. I staked everything on finding another vein. That either makes me a fool or a crook, and I know what they're going to call me.
God. And you made me believe you were going to be a success, and nothing was going to be too good for us.
We can start again.
In some desert, halfway across the world. My Australian cousins worked out gold mine. Repeat the same bloody pattern. No thanks.
We've got to go somewhere.
I haven't. I'm happy where I am, and I'm very fond of this house.
Well, let me tell you about this house. It's mortgaged to the rafters. It's collateral for at least 6 loans, which I cannot meet. I not only gambled with their money down that mine, I was wed long ago.
Then how the hell could we afford to go anywhere?
I've taken care of that at least. Oh.
I do not intend sitting at this table with a person like you any longer than I have to. So let's get it over as quickly as we can. This board proposes that the managing director, A.D. Hamilton, be dismissed. And that the affairs of the company be handed over to the fraud squad. Those in favor? Motion carried. I think that's all, gentlemen.
Now, just a minute. I want to put my side of the story.
You can do your talking to the police.
We've had enough, Hamilton. We've been misled for months by your reports.
You kept encouraging investment when you knew the tin was mined out.
No one ever knows for sure. There was a chance the mother lode continued on the lower strata. I was trying to salvage what we lost.
Lining your pockets, more likely, while we poured our money in. You lied to us here in this boardroom and in your written statements. Well, those documents are now in the hands of the police. I hope you get 5 years.
What do you mean the police have those documents?
We took that decision while you were in London. This is merely a formality.
That was bloody high-handed. I started this company. I sweated 2 years to make it work. You were all delighted to invest when you thought you'd make a fortune.
We were gullible. We didn't realize then what a crooked, thieving bastard you were.
Rosalind!
Present.
Present.
right, Alec?
Yeah, I'm fine. Never better.
Nobody in the car, and there's definitely no sign of anybody around the box.
We'll go back and make our report, Bill.
About taking sterling out of the country.
Yes.
How much are you taking, sir?
Oh, about 20 pounds.
Would you mind showing me your wallet?
No. That's 50 pounds in French francs.
May I see your bag, sir?
Yes, of course.
No traveler's checks or other kinds?
No, no.
Just this bag?
Well, I'm only staying a few days with some friends in Britain.
Return ticket, sir?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Pleasant journey, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
pointage du GIR annoncé le premier embarquement pour les passagers voyageant par le vol 861 en direction de Perth via Bombay et Singapour.
Hello, Prophecy. How are you?
Bloody boiling. There was a fella around looking for you, asking a few questions.
What about?
Golden Soap. Didn't come out to see you. If he turns up, his name's Westrop and he drives a flashy white utility. So how's your dad?
Oh, he's worried, you know.
Worry won't make it rain. He needs to relax more. Give him my love.
Okay.
Second thoughts. Better make that regards.
Prophecy.
This just came for you. It's from Paris.
For me?
Good news.
It's wonderful. Thanks, Maggie.
Really good news, eh? What did it say?
Leaving Paris tonight, arriving Perth Wednesday morning, will phone you, signed, Alec.
Who?
Alec Hamilton. You know, Cousin Rose's husband. I stayed with him last year in Cornwall.
Ah, I thought you didn't get on.
Well, that was with Rosa, not Alec. He'll be in Perth tomorrow.
Is Rosa coming with him?
I didn't say.
It's been a terrible shock, Inspector.
I'm sorry to intrude at a time like this, Mrs. Hamilton. We have been trying to contact you ever since we identified the car.
I was in London.
Visiting?
No. I'm sure you're aware by now, Inspector, that I'd left my husband.
On the same day as the accident?
Yes. But then I didn't know that there was going to be an accident.
Quite.
Do I have to identify the body?
We still haven't found a body. I'll let you know if that becomes necessary. Oh, you might take a good look round, check if anything's missing.
But why?
Routine.
Are you trying to suggest anything in particular?
Routine, Mrs. Hamilton. It's the only way we work. Your husband was in financial difficulties. Did you know that?
Oh, I had no idea. Well, how could I? There was the mine, this house, the way we lived.
Fraud charges are pending. Strange he didn't confide in you.
I don't think it's strange. We weren't exactly close.
Well, I will need to see you again when you've had a chance to get over the shock. I'll require some detailed answers then. Goodbye, Mrs. Hamilton.
Goodbye, Inspector.
Thank you.
Walked right past me.
Janet.
I thought it'd be nice for someone to meet you. Sort of welcome you to Australia. Truck's in the car park. Is that all your luggage?
That's it.
Right. Come on then. Sorry about the dust. Never noticed till I'm in town with all these clean cars. Was it a sudden trip?
Barely.
Will you be staying in Perth? Sorry. I'm asking all these questions. Probably got jet lag. Look, I've booked into a small motel. But if you're here just for a short time on a business trip, then...
No, a small motel will be fine.
Okay. How's Rosa?
All right.
I thought she might be with you.
No. Jan, thanks for meeting me. No one's ever driven 600 miles to meet me before.
Jan, Rosa and I have split up.
I'm sorry.
But not surprised.
No.
I may not go back to England.
Well, what about the company, the tin mine? Have you walked out?
More or less.
You got any money?
Don't worry, I can pay for dinner.
I'm afraid the insurance company won't pay up until the body has been recovered.
And what if they don't find a body? I mean, the car did explode.
But they could invoke a statute of limitations.
But that's years.
7 years.
Can't we get around that somehow?
Well, we could apply to the courts. It would take time.
But he's dead.
Formalities, Rose. The law's delay.
Oh, you're really not much help, Rupert.
There is one thing you could claim. I dare say they pay that immediately.
What?
The insurance on the car.
Yes, I could do that, couldn't I?
You're right. Best view in Perth.
Seems hardly a week ago I said that. Sudden decision, Alec.
Well, sometimes that's best. I'm going to need a job. Can you help?
How about one of the big multinationals? A man with your degrees. Or you could set yourself up as a mining consultant.
Well, that takes time. Money.
You've got time. Money needn't be a problem.
It is to a man who's just left his wife.
That's how it is. Sorry, Alec. Maybe that's why I never got married. My father said it was a disgrace not to carry on the family name. So what did he do in his life? Produced me and then never had the money to educate me. He came from Czechoslovakia. He ended up at the mine in Kalgoorlie, coughing his lungs out in a tin shack within sight of the Golden Mile. I wasn't sad when he died. Just... he'd been such a failure. End of the family history. So, you want a job?
Yes.
I've got nothing just at present.
Oh.
But there could be something later on.
How much later on?
Depends. I'm starting a mining newsletter. Inside tips for eager punters. You could be useful to me.
Huh.
Provide geological reports that would give weight to my recommendations.
Reports to order?
People have easy money they're dying to invest. Why shouldn't you and I make a profit?
And the punters, do they make a profit?
The world's full of punters, Alec. Think about it.
I will.
And keep in touch. Where are you staying?
Well, I may go up to the Pilbara. It's properly called Jarrabindo.
Garrity's place? Going to look at that mine, Golden Soak?
Probably while I'm there.
Was aptly named. It soaked up most of the Garrity money. Don't waste your time on it, Alec.
Well, seems I'll have the time to spare.
It's derelict. A bit like the Garrities these days, from all accounts. Still, you go and see for yourself.
Thank you.
Road goes on for 1,000 miles to Port Hedland. We turn off at Mundawindi.
Come in, Meg. I want to send a telex to London.
Morning, Bertie.
The traffic is worse than ever. Get me the Blackridge file, Mac.
Right. The reply has come for that telex you sent.
What telex?
The Connors in London, Lee Hamilton.
Oh, yes, read it to me.
Reference your inquiry, Alec Hamilton. Subject deceased.
What?
He's dead. Drowned 6 days ago after car crash into sea. Mining company reported in liquidation. Fraud squad inquiries had been instituted.
Well, well.
Shall I file it?
No, I will. Let's go, Mac.
Sweet home. Sorry I didn't tell you what it was like before. You'll see for yourself now.
When did it last rain?
9 months ago. It's one of nature's jokes on people like us. Trees flourish while everything else dies. Alec, when you meet my father, you will make allowances, won't you? Dad, this is Alec Hamilton.
Garrity?
Ed. Everyone just calls him Ed.
How's Rosa?
Well, she's fine, thank you.
Well, now you've seen it, you must be wondering why you came. I told Janet no one in their right mind would exchange the green hills of England for this.
Well, it's not always this bad. I can remember a spring when there was grass knee-high in the homestead paddock and wildflowers.
That's the trouble with this place. We all remember when it used to be better.
I think we could do with a beer. Dad, join us?
I've got to check. All the cattle are through Robinson's Gap. No water there either, but there's a week's feed. After that, if it doesn't rain. Cattle are our currency, Mr. Hamilton. There's nothing else of value here.
Sorry.
The way things are, I don't suppose I'd welcome a visitor either.
Well, now, don't you start. Come inside, I'll get you that beer. Leave the bags there. Is your room? Glasses on the shelf. My grandmother. When she and my grandfather built this house, they had over 1 million acres. They must have been great days here at Jayabinda before they discovered gold and soap.
It's about an hour's drive to the Garrity place and another 10 miles to Golden Soak.
So what?
So I'd say that's where you're heading. I know what you're after, mate.
You mean you'd like to know?
Listen, if a fly craps in this town, I know about it.
How long since it was worked?
About 30 years. The entrance is over there.
We can't go down with that light, Sir
Rose. Oh, I've never been down. Dad says the ladders are gone and the winch gear's broken. There was a cave in here years ago. Some men were killed.
Never make any money?
Oh, never. Well, never after the first few years.
They poured a fortune into it. And then, after the mine collapsed, well, by then, J.R. Bingham had been bled white. We had to sell the land to survive. I think my father hates this mine. And yet he won't sell. He won't let anyone near it. It's as if even now he still believes in it. Alec, you're a mining expert.
Well, yes, I know, but there may be gold there, probably is. But it may not be economically viable to mine it.
At least you could find out. Lay the ghost. Look, Alec, even after all the heartbreak this mine has caused, I still had the stupid, illogical feeling that somehow or other we're sitting on a fortune, a kind of Pandora's box. We just have to open the lid.
Yes, I know the feeling. Come on. We better get back.
We'll wait until dark.
Thought you might have had trouble with the ute.
No. I'll start dinner.
Help yourself to a drink.
Thanks. Can I get you one?
No, no, thanks. I don't use it much. Bean power?
Kundawana. I wanted to see Golden Soap.
You didn't go down.
Of course not.
You're wasting your time, you know. When Janet came back from that trip to England, she talked a lot about you. Not much about your wife, mostly about you. She said you'd come out here one day. I didn't believe that.
I don't think I did at the time.
So what brought you?
I wanted a new life.
Here? There's nothing for you here.
Mr. Garrity, your daughter invited me.
I realize that.
I think she hoped I'd find some way of reopening the mine.
The mine's finished.
I could find that out.
No. It's not only worked out, it's dangerous.
But, Dad, Alec could take samples. He could give us an opinion.
No, the mine's closed. Is that understood?
But he's only trying to help.
Maybe, but I don't need help.
You mean you won't accept it?
I mean I'm not having anybody, and I mean anybody, messing about down there.
Boss.
I'll be with you in a second, Tom. I'm sorry, Alec. But that's the way it is. I'm sure you'll find work done in Kalgoorlie or Perth. You're welcome to stay, but I expect Rosa wouldn't like it here.
I think you should know that Rosa and I are separated.
That's not the impression I got.
Dad, you know nothing about it.
Perhaps not. But if you hadn't taken him out to the mine, he'd have been here to speak to her himself. She telephoned 2 hours ago from London. Rang up to say she hoped you had a good trip and was glad to hear you were well. That was the message.
Why would you do that? Perhaps she's just trying to be friendly.
Not Rosa.
Then why?
Let me know I didn't get away with it. Make me sweat.
I'll just see how long he's going to be. Tom! Tom! Oh, there you are. Where's the boss gone? Thank you.
find Dad. He's headed for Golden Soak. Tom reported the two men were seen hanging around the mine. Dad's gone after them.
Why, well, dare say he can deal with it.
Alec, he's taken a gun.